You probably won't find everything you're looking for with your first try at searching. You'll often get a lot of irrelevant results, not enough sources, or maybe too many sources to comb through to find what you actually need. We call it research for a reason. Library research is a process. There's some trial and error involved, but the most effective way to improve your search results is to refine them by trying again based on what you learn from your first searches. Items in library catalogs or databases are tagged with subject headings. These are standardized terms used to describe sources. They give you a quick idea of what the book or article is about. When we say standardized, we mean that the same terminology is used to describe related sources. When you find a source that's relevant and useful for your project, look at its subject headings. You can often discover new useful search terms this way. You may learn some new vocabulary used by scholars or specialists that can help with your searches. For example, let's say I'm looking for books on World War II. I search for that in the catalog and find some books, no problem. When I click on one of the items I found, I notice the subject headings are actually World War 1939 to 1945. I'll make a note of that and try that in my next search. This term is also going to be useful when I go to databases to search for articles. Usually, the same vocabulary will be used in different search tools. I also start to notice that most of the books I find have specific subject headings for subtopics. Searching for World War 1939 to 1945 will find thousands of books. But if I click on one of these subtopics like underground movements or France, I'll get fewer results with a narrower focus, making it easier to find what I'm looking for. The abstracts included in most article databases are useful for discovering new search terms as well. They'll often mention terms or ideas you didn't think of the first time around. Let's say I'm still doing that paper on World War II history. I'm interested in the underground resistance movement in France. I found this article that looks relevant. Looking at the abstract gives me some new terms I didn't know. Looks like there were agencies called the Office for Strategic Services in the US and Special Operations Executive in the UK that I can search for as well. If you're using the advanced search feature of a database, here's a useful tip. Adding search terms connected by an OR will increase the number of possible results. You can connect synonyms or related ideas with an OR to expand your search, like education or college or university. This way you just have to match any one of your search terms, so it opens up your search to more possible searches. Connecting search terms with an AND narrows your search to fewer results. If you search for education and nursing, it focuses your search so you only get sources that include both words. You can use the and OR together. Go to Advanced Search, put synonyms together with OR in each search box, and connect your different ideas with AND on separate lines. The ORs give you a way to include different terms that might be in the source, and the AND lets you indicate that all of these ideas need to be included. A few more last tricks. Sometimes you can use any types of sources you want, and sometimes your professor will specify that you can only use scholarly journal articles, for example. It depends on the assignment. Many databases have a setting so that you can specify the type of source. For a lot of assignments, you'll need to use scholarly or peer-reviewed journal articles. Look for a button or a checkbox that says scholarly journals or peer-reviewed articles, something like that. Many databases also allow you to select books or other source types too, but peer-reviewed scholarly journal articles is the most common requirement your professor will assign. You can usually narrow down your search results by date. There may be a slider or a box to type in dates. This is useful if you know you only need recent sources. Most library databases let you search for a phrase by enclosing it in quotation marks. So if you search for Civil War in quotes, it'll find only those two words together, not the words civil and war separately. Usually, putting an asterisk in a search term finds anything that starts with those letters. Typing environment asterisk will find environment, environmental, environmentalist, and so on. Remember, even with all of these different strategies in your tool belt, searching for information is a process. This process will require you to think critically about what your information need is, the search terms that will get you the most relevant results, and what those relevant source results should look like. Throughout the process, it may be helpful to keep a research notebook while you're collecting information to outline what databases and search terms have resulted in the most relevant sources.